Hello and welcome to this demo. I would like to show you some of the layout enhancements in ADS 2009. First, let us start with an open layout window and notice the new toolbar on the top which has been added for ease of use. The icon with the red crossed arrows allows us to change the grid. For this example, let us use 0.5 microns grid with 2 microns for the minor and the major grids. Next, let us use the Insert Trace icon to place a trace on the layout page. Notice the window that pops out. We can input the width of the line and we can select the type of corner we want to use. Also, you can select which layer you want the line to be on. And you can also open NVIDIA configuration file. This configuration file helps you automatically connect all the lines with different layers together. So let us lay out a line on the M0 layer. So here's the line on the M0 layer. Next, I want to hit the period key on the keyboard to automatically change to the M1 layer. So you can see a via has been inserted automatically between the M0 and the M1 layer. And an M1 line in green, the green line, has been initiated. And here I'm using a bend to go vertically up. And I use another bend to route the line to the right. And next I will hit the period key one more time to go to the M2 layer, which is the red layer. And I draw the trace. So I have three traces now, M0, M1, and M2, all connected with vias. Next, let us select all the lines and convert them into transmission lines that can be transported to the schematic page for simulation and analysis. To do this, we select the whole structure and we click on the icon Convert Traces to Transmission Lines. This will automatically convert the traces we drew into transmission lines that can be taken to the schematic page for simulation and analysis. But before we do this, let us check the connectivity of our structure. Let us verify that everything is connected right. So we choose the icon Show Physical Interconnect. We can then click at any place in the structure to see how it is connected with the rest of the elements in the structure. So let me click here on the red line and notice the highlighted structure. Everything is connected through the layers and through the vias. To illustrate this further, let me add two vertical lines on the M2 layer. One is on the right side, as you see, crossing the M2 line on the right side, and the other one is over the M0 layer, crossing that M0 line, the blue line. So now if we use the icon Check Connectivity again on this structure, notice how we expect the M2 lines to be shorted because they are on the same layer, but on the left side, it shows that the M2 line is not highlighted because it is sitting on top of the M0 layer. So let us delete those two vertical red lines. And next, I would like to show you the split command demo. Now I would like to split this M0 line, the blue line. To do this, I go to the top and I select the icon Split Transmission Line. I click on it, and then I go to the transmission line, the blue one, click where I want to split it, and it will create two transmission lines. Next, I would like to take the left side of that split blue line, and I would like to change it to a different layer, to the M1 layer, the green layer. To do that, I will choose the icon on the top that says change the layer into green. And I click on that icon, and the left transition line as shown here is automatically converted into the M1 layer, the green layer. But now we have to add a via between the M0 and M1 layer. So we select the via from the palettes on the left side, and we just insert it. It's a via between the M0 and the M1. So now the two lines are connected. The two layers are connected with this via. Next, I would like to add a tap or a T element somewhere along the red line on the right side. To do this, I click on the tap icon as shown on the top, and I use it at the location where I want the tap or the T to be placed. So once you do this, it opens a window and you can select the width of that tap, and you can see by clicking on the line, I created a T or a tap for this line. Now I can attach a vertical line to that third port, the T structure. So let me do this. I use the insert trace icon again, select the width to be 25 microns, which matches with the T, and I can add this trace to this third port of the T structure that was created. And you can see that I can convert this trace into transmission line by clicking on the convert to transmission line icon. Next, let me demo the stretch command. So we click on the stretch icon and click on any line in the structure. So you can see we can stretch it out or we can stretch it back in. You can also select any line inside the structure and you can stretch it and it will move the whole structure up and down. For example, if we select this green line in the middle and use the stretch command up, so you can see the rest of the structure moves up with it, or you can move it back down. Now that we finished editing the structure in the layout page, let me show you how we can take it to the schematic page to do further simulation, analysis, and optimization. To do this, we use the command generate update schematic from the top schematic pull-down menu, as you see. So it opens a window and asks us, where do you like to start? So I choose the left side, and I say OK. And here we see the schematic of the whole structure has been automatically generated in the schematic page. It includes the lines, the bends, the vias, all the layers, just exactly as was created in the layout page. Using the toolbar in the schematic page, I can insert a template to help me display the results of the structure in data display. Next, I place an S-parameter controller to do S-parameter analysis, and I put 50 ohm terminations at the input and the output of the circuit. Then I click on simulate, so the simulation starts and the data display will open automatically, showing me the results of the structure. The Smith chart on the top left displays S11, and you can see S22 also on the bottom right, and this is S21, the transmission and the reverse transmission on the top right. So all the data, the S parameters, are displayed on this template. The main thing to point out here is we started the design in the layout page, and we brought it into the schematic page. And now in the schematic, we can do optimization, we can do further analysis, and then we can bring it back to the layout after we fix a design or finalize it. Let me next illustrate to you the different kind of synchronization between layout and schematic in ADS. From the options menu, if we hit on placement, you can see we have three types of synchronization: single, dual, and always design synchronized between schematic and layout. Three different kinds of synchronization methods. Let us choose the always design synchronize. And here I would like to show you how anything is placed on the schematic will automatically be placed in the layout page.